We had a fantastic week last week in the Waikato with the field days, the agricultural field days at Mystery Creek. Fantastic attendance, and first time I think for a long, long time we didn't have rain. I was there on the Saturday afternoon, and there were a lot of people that came through that I managed to talk to from the Taupo electorate, giving us a lot of feedback about the support that we as a government are providing to the primary production sector. And I thought I would just touch on a few of those. There is a one-pager that's come out, and if you log on to the website at www.louiseupston.co.nz, you can attach to the link there, and that's got a whole lot of the detail. One of the main things that we're doing is putting an extra $321 million into science, research and technology. And of course that's an extra boost from previous years, and it really recognises the importance of our primary sector and the importance to get the research right. And what we're actually focusing on is taking the science and the research and commercialising it, because we actually can't get export dollars if we don't take that critical step around commercialisation. The other main part of what we're looking at is the primary growth partnership, and I'm just checking my notes to make sure I get the figure right. $140 million into that. And again, it's really important that around our agricultural sector, we're continuing to invest in. This is a really important sector. Some of the other areas that we're providing support to the rural communities is around the additional money that's gone into health. And one of the areas that I'm particularly proud of that affects the Taupo electorate is the hard to staff areas. We've managed to obtain it for midwives. It also applies for rural vets, for teachers, doctors, nurses, and that's where a graduate who agrees to work in a rural area can have a significant amount of their student loan written off if they work in that area. So there's continuing support for that voluntary bonding for graduates who work in our rural areas. There's also money that's gone into education and infrastructure, and we'll see some of that money in our rural communities with the rollout of broadband in the rural areas, which is great. So I'd really urge you, if you're interested in the details of that, to have a look at that one pager. Give me a call if there's more information thereafter and I can track it down for you. The other thing that's been happening this week is Volunteers Week. I had a fantastic day yesterday in Cambridge and the South Waikato, out meeting with volunteers in our community, whether Salvation Army, whether it's the food bank, whether it's the services they offer in their community ministries. I went to a hospice shop in Cambridge, I've met with St John's, I've been in an ambulance, talked to volunteers, and I recognise that they're also our paid staff in those organisations. But it was the chance for me, on the behalf of our community, to say thanks very much for all the volunteers. There's over 1 million volunteers up and down New Zealand, but I know in the Taupo electorate we've got a stunning number of volunteers. Pick any sports event, pick any Saturday or Sunday that you're out on the sports fields, and there's coaches, there's managers, there's umpires. In schools there's always people volunteering, in the social services, as I talked about, in some of these shops that provide support for people on low incomes. It's just great to see the New Zealand spirit, and I'm particularly proud of the Taupo electorate for the volunteering spirit that we have up and down the electorate. So thanks very much. On Friday I'm going to be out with some more volunteers saying thank you on your behalf, and I look forward to seeing you in a couple of weeks.